Finally, we are dealing with scopes and error handling. By now, whenever an error happened, the flow stopped and we couldn't do anything after that. Now we want to handle them. So basically, we want to build the flow in a way that when an error happens, flow can still do something in that regard and continue. This lecture is a little bit long, so if you are busy with something else and you just came to this chapter to watch a few minutes of it and then continue later, please don't do that. This chapter requires quite a bit of attention, and I strongly recommend that you stay with me and do every single step with me. This is not one of those chapters that you want to just watch and probably implement later on. With all said, let's start and see what we're going to do. For this example, I want to get the items from an Excel sheet and import it to the product's demo list. All these items that I have here are electronics. So the item that I have here should be added to title, category for all of them, it should be electronics, and the unit price should come to the unit price column, all with flow. Probably you can do 90% of it. The only thing that you should learn here is how to connect to an Excel sheet. We will have a chapter about how to work with Excel, but keep this as just a quick introduction that how we can do that here. Not a big deal, but after we successfully did the transfer, we go back to SharePoint and manually delete all these records here. And then we throw a wrench in the process. So basically, instead of price for the projector, I put not applicable. And that will cause an error right in the middle of the process. What I'm trying to do, I want to make changes to the flow that transfers everything in the happy path to behave like when it finds an error, it just sends an email and continues with the next item rather than dropping the ball and not processing the other records. Are you ready for that? Let's start. We go to flow.microsoft.com and I want to create a new flow. And this flow is going to be an instant flow. And I would say error handling. Manually trigger a flow, I click on create. And now when I push a button, something is going to happen. Now, before I really start this, I want you to go to Excel, pause this video, and create a list of items like this. I want a few items and a few unit prices. The header is going to be item and unit price. Save it somewhere on your hard drive and continue watching the video when you are ready. Okay. So I assume you have this file created. Let me just save this file. Save, browse, and I want to save it here. I want to call it PRD list, and I just save it. So after you have these items, Flow cannot read the items from Excel unless they are in a table. So we need to convert this range of data to a table. Easiest way, you click on this dropdown and you say format as table, depending on the version of the Excel that you have, it doesn't really matter. They all support that. Just make sure you mark the my table has headers. So it assumes the first row is the column name. So I click on OK. A table is created. And if I click on the design tab, you will see that table has a name. I just changed the name from table one to TPRD list. You can call it anywhere regardless. I just put something that is self-descriptive so I know if I have multiple tables here, which one it is. We're done with this. And now we need to work with this. Keep in mind that Power Automate cannot reach a file on your computer. So if you want to read the items from this, you should put it either on OneDrive or somewhere inside SharePoint. And that's exactly what I do. My file is stored here. I go to SharePoint. Inside SharePoint, I pick just one library. It doesn't matter. I go to Documents. And I just drag and drop this file inside this library. So the file is uploaded to Documents Library inside SharePoint, and that inside the same SharePoint site that I'm dealing with, regardless, it can be anywhere. So now you want to bring all that information inside SharePoint and transfer the content from this Excel sheet to products demo list. This is the list that you're already familiar with. So this is what we do. To read those items, I add a new step and I search for Excel because I use it quite a lot. You see it in the list. If you don't see it, just search for Excel. And when I click on Excel Online Business, I can go for list rows present in a table. So I can get all the items in an Excel table. It works exactly like SharePoint get items. So I can go here and I can pick up the SharePoint site. And the SharePoint site that I had was Power Automate Workshop. Document library that the Excel file is there. Remember, it was in Documents. I can pick up the file by clicking on this button. It was PRD list. And now it automatically picks up all the tables in which there is only one table. I pick it up from here. And now I have everything from that Excel table inside Power Automate. Great. Show advanced options are there. You see that we also have OData, filter by, order by, and all those things. We really don't care about this one at the moment. At the moment, there is not much. We just want to bring everything that we have there to this flow. Going through these items, again, it's very easy. You're already familiar. It's going to be apply to each. Now, what we need to look for, we need to go for the list rows present in a table from this control. We need to get the value which has list of the items. This is the array that we have. So basically the list that it returns can be easily passed to apply to each. And now every item that comes here, we want to insert it into SharePoint list. Same thing, add an action, SharePoint. And this time, we are looking for create item. You are already familiar. There is nothing new. The only thing that is new is just one action that reads item in an Excel table. Everything else is exactly the same so far. Nothing new. Site address, we can pick it up, which is going to be our Power Automate workshop. And the list name, you got it. Products list demo. As soon as it's added, title is coming from that Excel sheet, which is going to be the item. Category, we decided that every item is electronics, and the unit price, of course, it's coming from this list. But again, because Excel does not have data types, this guy assumes everything that comes from Excel is a string, while unit price requires a number. What is the answer? Again, search for the item because it doesn't show it. Unit price under list rows present in a table. Click and the item comes here. So far, we can read the items from an Excel sheet and insert it into a SharePoint list. So I click on save and let's test it. I just test it here. I perform the trigger action, save and test. Now it has two connections, one to Excel, one to SharePoint. By the way, they don't necessarily need to be in the same place. They can be even in two different tenants. I click on continue, run flow. Done. Takes a few seconds, but then it's going to be complete. Flow completed successfully. Let's go back to our SharePoint and see if we got everything here. This is our USB key, wireless projector, Bluetooth speaker, and everything else. And this is exactly what we got in Excel. Just compare it side by side. USB key, wireless, earbuds, projector, Bluetooth speaker, USB Wi-Fi adapter. Fantastic. So far, it works pretty well. Now, let's delete all these items that I just added. Pick, and all of them. And I click on delete, so I delete all these items. Now, again, I need to go to not the Excel sheet that I have on my computer, the Excel sheet that is on SharePoint. I just open it. And projector, I change the price to NA. It automatically saves. I have no problem with that. List of the products does not have those items. Let's run the flow one more time. So I go back to Power Automate. I click on edit again. So we run the test again. Save and test. Run flow, done. And happily ever after. Hopefully it works. We keep our fingers crossed. And again, as expected, we get an error. Why? Because NA is not a number. So what happened here? If I go to my apply to each, you see actually there are all the items here. It says 5 items are processed. If I come back here, you see there are only 4 items added. Projector does not exist here. It did the job. At this step, it failed, but it continued with the Bluetooth speaker and USB Wi-Fi adapter. What happened? Let's go back to Power Automate and see inside it. If I start with the first item, create item worked perfectly. Next, worked perfectly. Still it's happy. Next, failed with the error that I have. And it continued with the next one, and it continued with the next one. Pretty complex, right? Let me go back to edit and explain the problem. So what happened here, apply to each works like a single scope of work. So one iteration, if there is an error, that iteration fails. So if I have anything else after create item on the third iteration, it does not continue by default. It says, okay, one iteration failed. Pass on and go to the next one. So if there is one more thing, okay, insert that item, then do one more thing, it fails. The second thing will not continue. The other thing is that as a SharePoint user, I will never be notified that something has failed unless I come to Flow Administration and actually check the run history, like here. Okay. I see, hold on a second, something failed. And I dig into it and I finally find it. There is no other way. What I'm trying to do today now is I need to check right away after every item creation. If an item fails, I want to capture that item and email it to someone. So far, we have the problem definition. So with all this, let's go to the next lecture, see what are the tools that we have that we can go around it and then utilize them to solve this issue.